Google's been asking us if we're feeling lucky for almost 30 years. But who needs luck when you've got AI mode? It's like search upgraded for modern times. But if you use it like regular search, you're going to miss everything that makes it powerful. So in this video, I'll show you how to unlock the full potential of AI mode today. Then I'll share what's coming soon and how it really stacks up against ChatGPT and Perplexity. I'm David, let's search smarter together. When AI mode launched, I expected this magic button on the Google homepage. But here's the homepage and I don't see anything. Turns out it's US only and you still might not have it until you go to google.com/AI mode. If you're not seeing what's on my screen, you'll need to log in to a personal account, not a business account. And that means no incognito mode either. Once you see this, click on opt-in to search labs to get access. Then you can click on try AI mode. To get AI mode on your iPhone or Android device, make sure you've downloaded the latest version of the Google app. Then open the app, tap the labs icon in the top left corner of the screen, then swipe down to the new experiments section and tap try AI mode. So what exactly is this new feature? Let's clear that up right now. If you've used ChatGPT with search before, you already know how game-changing AI plus search can be. AI mode is basically Google's take on this. You type in a prompt, just like with ChatGPT, press the enter key or click the blue arrow to submit your prompt, and then you'll get your answer directly on the results page instead of a list of links. But wait, I hear you say, isn't that the same thing as AI overviews in search? Let's compare the two by clicking on the All tab to go back to standard search. I'll expand the AI overview section at the top, and look, it's very similar to AI mode. So here's the deal. AI overviews are good for quick information and fact finding, but AI mode is for a lot more. Let's go back by clicking the AI mode link. Use it for exploration or tasks with multiple steps. Because now that I've asked about the best productivity techniques, I can go one step further and ask which one works best for people who do deep work and don't have many meetings. After clicking the blue arrow, you'll see Google kicks off 7 searches and goes to over 150 sites to get the answer. Once it finishes, you'll get a 1-to-2 page summary of all of that research. Now, in this summary, you'll notice a couple of link icons in gray circles. These are citations. Click any one of them to view the original sources the AI pulled from for this part of the answer. But this is more than just glorified text search. For example, on your phone, you can search with a photo by tapping the camera icon on the search box. Then once you've got your subject in frame, you can tap on the magnifying glass to take the photo. Then ask any question you want about it to get a quick answer. And again, after it kicks off multiple searches and looks across hundreds of sites, you'll get an answer that leaves you informed and confident about whatever your next steps are. Back on the laptop, let's check out a couple more real-world scenarios. As a quick tip, when you want to switch to a new topic, click the new chat icon in the left sidebar. This tells AI mode that you want to start fresh. A lot of people spend hours trying to find the right product and the best deal for it. But AI mode is changing the game. For example, this week I was looking for a high-quality men's rain jacket. Before, I would go to a brand that I liked and search their catalog. Now I can give my specific preferences to Google and get some great recommendations. And check this out, the full prompt isn't scary. I cover the sizing, durability, price preferences, and the color. And funnily enough, it took me 20 minutes to decide with the old way that this is the jacket I wanted. With AI mode though, I could have seen the descriptions of all of these different jackets and looked for best prices. And really soon, Google's taking this one step further. Let me show you how. In the Google shopping experience, which is integrated here, I can click on the track price button to receive notifications when the price drops. Soon you'll be able to change that notification to only go out when the item falls below a certain price. Then when you get notified, you can check out directly from the notification. But what if you're not just searching? You actually want to see how a product would look on you. Google's taking this even further. Back on the home screen of the Google app, I'll tap the labs icon to access the experiments page. Then I'll swipe down just a little bit until I see the try on experiment and tap turn on. Then I'll head back to the home screen and access AI mode by tapping on the magnifying glass. Let's see what's different about that rain jacket search now. I can tap the history icon in the top right to see my past searches. And halfway down the page, I see my rain jacket search. Now, I did this search earlier, so the result and the formatting looks slightly different. Still, I was recommended the Patagonia jacket. When I tap on it, I'll see a new option called Try It On. And here, I'm asked to upload a photo to try it. So let's choose something from my photo library. This photo looks pretty good. It's got good lighting and it's a full body shot and front facing. So let's try done. After about 30 seconds, we'll see the magic happen. And here's me with the Patagonia jacket on. And if we look at this image and the original side by side, it's honestly incredible what Google has accomplished here. Now, this is all available today, but some of the most exciting stuff is just around the corner. Here's what we have to look forward to. Up first is deep search, which considers even more individual searches and potentially several hundreds of web pages to put together a fully cited report. Now, from the marketing material that Google shared, this seems very similar to deep research in Gemini, just without the research plan. We'll have to wait to see more. Next up is bringing agent capabilities to search. Soon, you'll be able to start tasks that connect to multiple different sites. Here, for example, we're looking at purchasing baseball tickets without having to go through to the ticket site. But really, the sky's the limit. You could imagine searching for specific recipes and buying the ingredients on Instacart automatically, or adding the results of search pages to a Google Sheet. Last up is Search Live. Imagine collaborating with AI on a real-world project.
What else should I do to make it stronger?
To make it stronger, consider adding more triangles to the design. Also, ensure a strong bonding between the popsicle sticks by using wood glue and clamping or taping the joints while they dry.
Now that's the near future, but how does AI mode really stack up against other AIs right now? If you're already using ChatGPT in search, then AI mode in Google will feel familiar. And you're not missing much, at least not yet. But personally, I'm canceling my Perplexity Pro subscription because to me, Google's results are just as trustworthy. Now the future I'm really excited for, and I'm sure is scary for some of you, is that Google knows you better than anyone. That means someday AI mode will harness all of your email, your calendar, even your chats to surface events you'll actually like, restaurants that fit you perfectly, and travel planning in one click. I'm David. Drop a comment with how you're using Google's AI mode today, and I'll see you in the next video.